Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Russ Courtnall Be a Pro series in NHL 16 on the Xbox One. We are anxiously awaiting the arrival of NHL 17 and what it may bring for the career mode for the Be a Pro, whatever they're going to call it. But for the meantime, jumping back into my Russ Courtnall series, just hoping I don't get demoted back to the minors anytime soon, as we'd like to stick around here with the Arizona Coyotes taking on the Anaheim Ducks tonight, and hoping to build on our winning season so far. Record of 25-20-6 entering play tonight against the Ducks. You see pregame skate happening now. We're just about ready to get underway from the pond in Anaheim. And away we go. Let's see if we can strike first in this one. I put the Ducks in their Stadium Series jerseys, which I think are pretty sweet. Oh my goodness, what a save right there coming across the crease. Almost a desperation save as that goes in the corner, but the Coyotes continue to possess the puck in the zone, putting shots on net, some of these being blocked, and finally a save right there and a cover-up by Gibson in the net, but nice pressure right off the bat for the Coyotes on their power play. Got to take a look at this replay as Courtnall almost had himself an assist. The pass over to Richardson, and look at this blocker save by Gibson as he sprawled across the crease. Okay, continuing on this power play. Richardson gets this to an open shot on the point, and then Courtnall fans on a shot. He's going to get this back to the point, though, and trying to get this on net. Again, continuing to pepper the Ducks netminder, but he stands tall. All but 2 seconds killed off of this Coyotes power play. So now further into the first period, working this around in front. There is a pass that'll set up a goal by Courtnall. He gets the first assist on Richardson's goal. He had an open look himself, but he decides to unselfishly dish it off to Brad Richardson. Let's watch it again as the pass right in front. Yeah, he gets it to someone with a little bit better look than himself. And, well, that's what Courtnall's out here to do. First and foremost is to be a playmaker and set up his teammates. So he does just that and gets the Coyotes on the board with a 1-0 lead. They stretch that to 2-0. Before the first period is out. And into the second here now, we pick up the action. And, oh, a glorious chance right in front. Courtnall get the puck all alone, but Gibson makes the save. Bid to make it 3-0 is not going to go for Courtnall. You see the replay again. Standing right there, gathers the puck, and gets the wrist shot on. But that is a glove save by Gibson to deny him. So we got a Ducks power play now. Just 3 minutes left in the period, and the pass in front, the one-timer is in the back of the net. So they get on the board for the first time. The Ducks crowd finally has something to cheer about as they're back in this game now, just a 2-1 deficit. Power play goal gives the Ducks new life. So here we are into the third period now, winning a faceoff. That's a block on the shot, but the Coyotes keep it in, cycling around here. Back to the point, pass in front to Courtnall. That shot might have hit somebody in the head, and it ends up on the stick of Richardson again. He's got his second goal of the night. I don't think Courtnall's going to get an assist, but he had a hard shot that stunned the defenseman, and the play continued, and eventually this pass right on Richardson's tape, and he lets a low, hard shot go that beats the goaltender stick side and gives Arizona their two-goal lead back. They're playing a nice road game right now in the third period. Got about 16 minutes left. In our defensive end here, that is going to be saved by Lindback into the corner. Here comes Courtnall with a pass, and forget a line change. He's going for this partial breakaway. Oh, he's taken down. What are they going to call? They're calling penalty shot. I guess it was a clear enough breakaway after he beat them by the benches. He gets dragged down, and he will indeed be awarded a penalty shot. Now, this is a blessing and a curse because I am not good whatsoever at dangling and deking, but maybe one solid move and I can beat Gibson. Let's try it. Courtnall just going to keep it simple here. He's going to go backhanded. Nope, Gibson's waiting for him, so he would not bite. Probably should have made a forehand move before the backhand, but it is what it is. He's stopped on the penalty shot. Remains 3-1, but we've got a power play now with about 10 minutes to play. That's a save by Gibson, and chipping away at that is Courtnall, the defenseman, not too happy with that right there. There'll be some pushing and shoving, another face-off win with about 6 minutes to play now, cycling this around. And will we get a shot from the point? Eventually, yes. And oh my goodness, it was tipped in front by Courtnell. He gets the redirection, but it rings off the pipe at least once, if not twice. Very lucky is Gibson here that this puck does not end up in his net. Whoa, yeah, it looks like he got a piece of it, then it hit the post, but it stays out. Arizona closes off, which is a nice road victory here by a score of 3-1. They're able to take it. Courtnell gets a helper in this one, and the Coyotes get their 26th win of the season. Your three stars, Brad Richardson, Anders Lindback, and you've got Stone as the third star. Courtnell does not factor in that with one assist, but he does get on the score sheet with the helper. So next up is the Vancouver Canucks, and we're throwing this back, guys. We are throwing this back for both teams. We're going way back for the Coyotes when they were the Winnipeg Jets. Yes, I know the Jets are back in the league, but the Coyotes franchise was once the original Winnipeg Jets franchise, so we've got the throwbacks. Oh, peppering the net again to start a game. Lots of point-blank chances. Courtnell's thwarted there. Oh, a great pass right there, and he stops him again. Looked like it was going to be another assist. Still swarming. Courtnell, can he get a shot off? No, he goes for a pass. That is stopped. Mayhem in the crease. This puck is still loose. Another chance. Misses wide. These guys got to be tired for all the rubber they're throwing on the net here. Finally a stop. My goodness, what a flurry in the first couple minutes of this hockey game. But again, nothing to show for it. Coming into the zone here now. Courtnell's going to take this behind the net. He gets spilled, but he gets back up looking for a pass. And this eventually ends up in the net. Took two or three whacks, but Lesio puts it home. I think Courtnell's going to get an assist on this as he made a nice play centering the puck from behind the net. Good effort to not give up on the puck after being knocked down. Yeah, he will get the second assist on this. Richardson the other as they whack away, and Markstrom is not able to keep that out of his net. You see the net camera there. Oh, was it kicked in? Ooh, I don't know. Was that a kicking motion? They're not reviewing it, so it's going to stand. 1-0. Arizona, this is a errant pass from the Canucks. It goes all the way down to their end, and then what happened? The puck is in the net. Are you kidding me? I was going off for a line change with Courtnell. Didn't see what happened. Okay, so we didn't even put this down the ice. It was a centering attempt to the point that got away. And, oh, you see Markstrom misplays it. Leaves a juicy rebound right there. And Vermette buries it. So, very sloppy play by Vancouver all around right there. Leads to a goal. And it's 2-0. Just under a minute left in the first period. As you see a save right there, but he wants to give it up. Oh, bad idea as Courtnell picks that off. Now skating around the zone. Finds his man. Gets it back. He puts it in the net. That's a goal for Courtnell with just seconds left in the period. 35.2 to be exact. He beats Markstrom and it's 3-0. Yeah, he would have been better off covering that puck because it did not work out well once this thing was skated around in the zone. And nice pass and gets it right back and is able to get that five hole on Markstrom. At least I think it went through the five hole, or did he beat him stick side? Either way, it's in the net and it's 3-0. Into the second period now on a line change, jumping over the boards. And so often, this is what happens. You hit the ice and the puck ends up in the back of your net. I get the feeling so often that line changes are forced at a predetermined time here and not necessarily contextual to what's going on the ice. Sometimes players leave a bad situation just to get you on the ice. That's not good. Here's a turnover. Courtnell has got a 2-on-1. What can they do here? Pass to Lesio. Lesio back to Courtnell. He scores his second goal of the night. What a pretty play there by Lesio and Courtnell on the 2-on-1 break. And Courtnell buries it. It's now 4-1 Coyotes. Courtnell for MVP? Well, yeah. How about just keeping him in the NHL instead of sending him back down all the time? He'll settle for that. And he'll settle for his second goal of the game, getting this place absolutely unglued in the stands as they love what's going on here against Vancouver. Maybe they should wear the Winnipeg Jets throwbacks all the time, although I think the Jets organization would have something to say with that. Whatever, we're safe for tonight. Here's a face-off win. A slap shot is sticked aside, but the Coyotes keep after it. Pass in front. Courtnell scores. He scores again. It's a hat trick with just 3:38 to play. Oh, man. He almost peeled back on defense, but finds that there is a wide open space right in front of the net. And Richardson to Ryder to Courtnall. Courtnall puts it under the bar, and it is his third goal of the night. Nice shot from Netcam right there as he beats Markstrom for the third time. So he's got the hat trick. But you know what? This game is not over. It's 5-1, and here they come again. Nice pass. Gets it back. Oh, my goodness. Look at the passing on this play. Again, he had a chance to maybe bury his fourth goal of the game. Instead, he reciprocates the favor back to Lesio, getting him on the board. And that's an assist for Courtnall. Pretty play right here as they had the goaltender going side to side. Look at that. He could have gone backhand maybe. Maybe get stuffed instead. Back to Lesio, where Markstrom has no chance and no momentum, sliding over in time, and they get the goal. So it's 6-1. Courtnall, how about a little highlight package of his night and his three goals? Never mind the assist. He's got the hat trick in this one. And there's number one. This was the pretty two-on-one for number two. And cue up the third goal of the night, working hard in front, getting open in a nice spot, and making it 5-1 at the time. It's going to be a 6-1 final as Courtnall has himself a night. Three goals, two assists, and I would imagine the first star of the game in a 6-1 drubbing of the Vancouver Canucks. By the way, I didn't even get to mention it. I was talking about my uniforms so much, but that uniform set there from Vancouver from the early 90s, one of my favorites in hockey. Always enjoyed the flying skate logo. Back in the Trevor Linden and Pavel Bure days. So he does indeed get the first star of the game. We are leading the Pacific Division right now by a couple points ahead of the San Jose Sharks and the Calgary Flames. We're sixth by record in the West. However, we are division leader. And we've got to be pretty happy where we're sitting right now, but we want to obviously climb the ranks of the Western Conference. We'll see you next time for more Ross Courtnall. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.